This is how this is our today's topic, pod design. So what we are going to do is, here you can see I've drawn the border of 2 cm. I've mentioned today's date, I've mentioned today's topic name, pod design. And now what you have to do is, you have to draw a pod with your own design. Okay, it's on you, however you want your pod should look like. You can make a pod of your own design. Okay, so this is how I have made. What I have done, I have used a pencil to make draw a pod, and then I have taken a black marker and I have given the outer border. Okay, so now what we have to do is, just look at this. Here I have taken the water. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is, just pay attention how you're going to do. Yes, it's on you, whatever color you want. You can make any color, you can take any color. Okay, and now what you have to do, dip the brush in the water and make a wash of water. Okay, give a wash of water, and then what you have to do is, you just have to see, you just have to spread the, see, this is how it's flowing. Yes, this is the flowing technique. Yes, just look at this. You just have to place the brush and your color is going to flow. Yes, as you can see how the color is flowing. You can take another color. Here I'm using a yellow color. Just look at this. Then I'm going to take an orange color. Just look at this, how the color is flowing. You can use various colors. Okay, aapko jitne colors use karna, you can use the colors. See, just look at this. This is the way how it's flowing. Yes. Use more amount of water and less amount of color. Yes. So this is how you. Now just look at this. Here I'm using a wash, and just look at this, how the color is flowing. Yes. This is how you're going to do it. Then here I'm going to use a green color. Just look at this, how the color is flowing. Just look at this. See how the color is going to flow. Just look at this. Yes, this is your flowing technique. I hope each and everyone has understanding this. This is your flowing technique, how you're going to use. Just look at this, how the color is going to flow. Yes, this is your flowing technique. Now what you have to do is, we are going to make the flowers. So now I'm going to show you how to make a blowing technique. Yes, here I'm using water. I'm making a drop in this way. Okay, just look at this. Now just pay attention. Yes, this is your blowing technique. Just look at this. Yes, you can use a lighter shade also. Just look at this. Yes. Here we are making the stem of the flower. just look at this. This is how you're going to do it. Yes, and now at the end, you have to make the flower. So just look at this. Here I am using a red, and just look at this. This is how I am just dipping the brush in this way. This is how you are going to make the flower. You can use a yellow shade in this. Just look at this. The flower, I'm using a yellow shade. Just look at this. Same way you can also do this. Red. Yes, you can make some various colors of flowers in this way. You can just dip the color and just look at this. This is how we have done this. You can use some much more dark shade for adding in the pot. You can add a dark in this way. I hope each and everyone is understanding this topic, how to do this. Just look at this. Yes, and now again what we are going to do, we are going to dip the green color over here in this part. We are going to take the water. Just look at this. Yes, as you can see, how many various types of color has been coming. Just look at this. Yes, it went too much out. You can take some color over here in this way. Yes, just look at this. This is how you can make the stems. Okay, and then for coloring the flower, you can do one thing. You can just make 2, 3, 5 dots over here in this way, and then you can take another shade. Just look at this. Here I've taken yellow, then I'm taking orange. And then at the end, I'm taking red color. Now what you have to do is you just have to drop some water on this. And just blow it out. Yes, take the excess water out. Let it dry, and then we'll give some much more shades in this. Okay, let it dry properly, and then we'll add a darker tone in this. How you're going to do it, just look at this. You can add some much more this way you can make the flowers. Add the shades, red, then I'm adding some orange shade in this, and at the end I'm using yellow. So just look at this. This is how you're going to do it. just look at this. This is the way how you're going to color the flowers. Yes, and at the end you can give some shadow to the pot over here in this way. You can add the shadow. Just look at this. Yes, this is our today's topic, pot design with blowing and flowing technique. Now what you can do is you can take a black pen. Okay, you can take a black pen. Here I don't have a black pen, I have a blue pen. So just look at this. You can make some design on this. Using a black pen, you can add some designs in this, or a black marker also you can use. You can use black marker also. Just look at this. This is how I'm adding the designs in this. As your color get dried, you can add some designs in this. Yes, just look at it. Yes, so this is how you're going to do it. This way you can draw the leaves. Yes, as I told you, as the color get dried, you can add a darker shade and you can just highlight it. Just look at this. Yes, this is your blowing and flowing technique. I hope each and everyone has understood this. Same way, same method. What you can do is you can make another design of a pot. You can make various designs. Okay, so let's do it one more time. Here I'm making another pot with a different design. So as you can see here, I have made another pot design. Same way, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create the outline. Okay. This is the way how I'm doing it. Just look at this. Okay, so now I've done this. Now what I'm going to do is, just look at this. Just look at this. Now what I'm going to do is, here I'm going to take a water. I'll just change the water. The water has become dirty. So I'm just changing the water. You have to take a clean water, and then, as I've told you earlier, what you have to do is take the brush, dip the brush, take the color, and just flow it in this way. Just look at this, how it's flowing, yes. Just look at this. I'm using orange color. And just look at this now. How it's going to flow? Just look at this. Now just look at this. Can take another shade, and you just have to shadings on this in this way. Use the shades, let the color flow. Yes, the paper is absorbing the water. If your paper is not absorbing, it will give you a proper look. Okay, just look at this. Just have a look on this. Yes, just look at this, how the color is flowing. Yes, this is the way how your color is going to flow. It's naturally it's flowing. Yes, I'm not doing anything, the color is flowing naturally. So same way we have to do it. Just look at this, and just look at this now. Yes, as you can see, the color, the flow of the color, how its color, how the color is flowing. Yes. Just look at this. This is the way how you're going to do it. You can take a dark blue shade also. Any colors you want, you can use in this. Just look at this. And now I'm going to use a green color shade. So for here, I'm just putting some colors, and just look at this, how it's flowing. Yes. Just look at this. You can use a light shade. Just look at this. Yes, you can use a light shade in this and just dip the brush in the color. Yes, so this is your blowing technique. Now I'll show you how to blow it. So what you have to do, you just have to make a drop over here in this way. Little bit of color and water. Just blow it out. See, just look at this. Yes. It's too much fun, yes. So this is the way how you're going to do it. Just look at this. Yes. I hope each and everyone is understanding this, how to do it. Just look at this. Yes, this is the blowing technique. Just look at this. Just look at this. Here we have done this. Here I'm using red. Then I'm taking some orange. Then I'm taking some yellow. Some blue. And dark blue. Just look at this. Just look at the shade, how it's forming. Yes. So as you can see, here we have made this kind of pot design. And now you just have to make the flowers in this way. Yes. Here I have made a blue one. Now I'm making the red. Yes, after this red has been done, I'm going to make an orange one. Yes. This is the way how you're going to do it. As you can see, I'm adding some shades in this. Yes. This way you can do it. You can make a flower of in this pattern also. Add some different colors of shade in this yellow. Yes, just look at this. So this is the way how you're going to do it. You can draw some leaves over here. Yes, I hope each and everyone is understanding this, how to do this. Again, so you can make one more color shade this way. Just look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. In this way also you can make the flower. Just look at this. Yes, I hope each and everyone is understand this topic. You can use some dots in this way. You can use a dot and you can make a flower in this way. Yes, for this I have used orange, using some red for showing the darker tone, and for showing the lighter tone I am using yellow. In this way you can do it. Yes, I hope each and everyone has understood this topic. Is there any doubt to any of the student? Just look at this. Yes, we have made here. We have completed two pots. Yes, we have completed two pots. At the end, what you have to do is you just have to